How do you control data entry with a user form? I have a very simple example here, a small database with 6 entries. And certain entries are regulated what you can choose. When the user presses the home key, this user form will pop up. You type the last name in there, the date of birth. The gender box is a combo box with 2 options. Hired on by default, today's date kicks in. Another combo box, 3 options in a list box. How do you create this? Open Visual Basic, Alt F11. And make sure that you start in your project a user form and a module. A user form and a module. Here is the user form. I added from the toolbox certain controls. The A1 is a label. I did that 6 times. Make sure that you have in the left panel also the properties box open. You do that through the button properties. And in the properties box, you can regulate how do you name things, etc. So to show you how to do that, you click on the drop down box there and you select the entity you want to regulate. So once you have put labels here, you type in the labels. Let's say I have last name. I make sure that the caption is the way I want it to be. Then we do something similar for these boxes. They need a little more work. The first one, text last name, I named TXT for a text box last name. Combo boxes I named CBO something, list boxes LST something. You can regulate the border style, you can regulate the font, and sometimes you want also to regulate the tab index. That means when the user tabs, it goes from 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Once we have done that, we want to put code behind that user form. Notice that you have 2 buttons here in your Project Explorer. The first one gives you the code, the second one gives you the boxes where you design things. I'm going to the code window there. And I started the sub user form activate. How do you get it? By selecting user form. And then from this drop down box, the activate event. In the activate event, I add my default values. The combo box gender has the F option and the M option. The combo box hours has 40, 35, 30. The list boxes has 3 cities or whatever you want. I put in text hired today's date by default, so the user doesn't have to type that one. And I disable the command button add employee, so people cannot do that yet when the user form gets activated. Later on, when they click on the add button, they can only do that once it's enabled. We are going to do the following. And where did we enable all of this? When someone entered the list city box, it's the last box, list city, enter, then we enable the command button. Once the command button is enabled, and people click on the button, we have to store the information from all the boxes on the user form. I need a variable of the long type, and in that variable R, I store the next empty row number. So we take from sheet 1, I assume you have only one sheet, sheet 1, range A1, that's the beginning of the database, give me the current region. That means all the rows and columns up to an empty row and an empty column. And count those rows. So if I have 6 rows, then R is 6. Then I'm going to talk to that sheet cells R plus 1, that is the next row down, which is the empty one, in column 1. From that cell, we are going to offset 0 rows, 0 columns, and put in there whatever is in the text box last name. In one column to the right, put whatever is in the text box date of birth, format it as date time in case the user didn't do that properly. And in the next one, the gender, the higher date, maybe you want to also format that as date time. Whatever is in the combo box hours as a chosen option, and whatever they chose in the list box. Then we empty all these controls on the form and we disable the list box again. When the user wants to close the user form by clicking on the X in the right top corner, then the user form query close event kicks in. Remember, you find that here, user form, query close event. And I'm going to do a simple check. If the first text box is not empty, that means you haven't really added an employee yet, for when you add an employee, it empties the text box. Then I cancel the close event. I took this cancel option from the query close event, set that to true, and give a message box, the record was not saved yet. So the user cannot close the user form until the record has been saved. That's all done in the user form code of this project. How do we call that user form? We do that in a module. A module has macros in it and things like that. So I create in module 1, double click on module 1, after you had inserted the module. We create a subroutine that I called open the data form. And I call the user form 1, I did not give it a name. Otherwise, it would be something like USF, my data form, dot show. And if you don't say anything, it is VB modal by default. That means you cannot click on the sheet while that form is open. So the user has to deal with that form first. That is probably the best choice. If you don't want that, you have to set that to VB modal. How do we call this up? You can give it a shortcut. Control, Shift, O, or something like that. I'm going to give it a different kind of shortcut, the home key. So how can you implement a different shortcut than the shortcuts you usually do for macros? You do that in the workbook open event. Double click on this workbook and implement there for the workbook the open event. And set a key for Excel. Application.onKey has two arguments. What is the key? Double quote inside braces, the home key, and comma, the name of the subroutine, open data form. So each time when the workbook opens and the user clicks on home, it automatically does the open data form 1, which was this one. It shows the user form 1, and at the moment you show the user form 1, you go through the activate event, and it does all of this automatically. So we did that in this workbook on key. Then save the whole file as an XLSM file. M stands for a macro, otherwise you lose your macros. Then you open the file and you test everything with the home key. Let's do the test. I saved everything, I opened everything. Each time I press the home key, I get this form. Let's say we want to enter a new employee, Mr. or Mrs. White. Date of birth 1/1/1985. Tab, the gender. Let's say it's a female. Hired on today's date, hired for 35 hours, and that person is from New York. At the moment I went into the city box, the add employee button got enabled. So I click on add employee. And notice everything was nicely entered here. I cannot click here because this form was VB modal. I can add a new one. I can close this box if I'm ready. If I want to open it again, the home key. And at the moment you type a new name in there, say Mr. Kelly, etc., etc., etc. Let's do it one more time. Done for 35 hours from Tokyo. If I try to close the form now, notice that Kelly is still there. So it will say record not saved. Okay. I add the employee. And now I can close my form. So I get a very consistent data entry. You need to know much more probably. I gave you some hints and some tools. I developed a CD-ROM for you on VBA in Excel. It has 3 parts, more than 1500 slides. They discuss all these issues extensively. They have in-between interaction tools to find out whether you got everything right. And you can get this CD-ROM from MrExcel.com, Amazon.com. Just type my name, Gerard Verschuren, in there and you will find all the tools I developed for you. I hope I gave you enough tools to get started.